Hi everybody and welcome to another tutorial, and today we're going to be talking about InkScape. And InkScape is a vector drawing software for Windows, macOS, and Linux, and the nice thing about it, and to coin my favorite word, it's absolutely free. And today we're going to show you everything you need to know to begin using InkScape for 2025. InkScape is great when designing and loading drawings online, as it manages scalable vector graphic files, or SVGs, where vector shapes are described by a textual markup language. This allows you to save size with respect to pixelated images. Make sure to check our video description to watch our comprehensive Udemy course if you want to learn more about InkScape after this video. When you open InkScape, the welcome screen shows up with options to select between a light or a dark solid color for your canvas, the shortcuts list you prefer, and on appearance, the icons of the interface. You can also turn on the dark theme. Switch to Time to Draw to select the canvas size and orientation for your new document from several templates available. This opens on the main interface with a big preview of your canvas, the toolbox on the left, and several panels on the right. You can retrieve any missing bar or panel from View, Show, Hide. To manage your canvas, go to File, Document Properties. On Display, set its size, orientation, fix the measurement unit to use. You can also change the color for the canvas and its background, called Desk. You can also enable the Pages tool to adjust the canvas size directly on the preview, or add new pages by clicking and dragging. To start drawing, enable any tool from the toolbox and get useful tips on how to use it from the status bar at the bottom. At the top, the tool's control bar lists several options for the current tool. The first tools at the top of the toolbox allow you to drop regular shapes by clicking and dragging on the canvas, holding down the Control or the Command key to match width and height for squares and circles. Use Control or Command and Z to undo any action. More below. Enable the Pen tool to draw custom shapes, clicking on the canvas to drop straight and consecutive segments, and clicking and dragging to drop curves. Double-click to close the shape with automatic fill. At the top, change the drawing mode as you need. Enable the Pencil tool to drop freehand shapes by clicking and dragging on the canvas. Switch to the Calligraphy tool to drop strokes with fill that follow your brush trace, adjusting size and other parameters from the top. Use the Text tool to drop single line text by clicking once on the canvas, and a multi-line paragraph by clicking and dragging. If text is clipped, make sure to extend its box until it comes back to blue. At the top, adjust text properties such as font, style, size, alignment, spacing, and orientation. These are applied on the entire text, unless you select any part of it. To edit text color and transparency, you have to use the Fill and Stroke panel that we're going to see shortly. To check the canvas, zoom in and out with your mouse wheel while holding the Control key or the Control plus command on Mac. You can also pan around with the spacebar key while not editing any piece of text. InkScape comes with useful aids. Two rulers at the top and on the left show your cursor position with the measurement unit chosen. From the top right corner, You can also turn on and off snappings entirely or on specific ways, such as bounding boxes for object edges and key points, nodes for cusp and smooth object nodes, and alignment to be always aligned. Switch to the Advanced node for more options. To manage the objects of your canvas, use the Selector tool. Click on any object to select it, and click and drag it to move it. Use its black nodes to resize it, holding down the Control key or Command on Mac to maintain the original aspect ratio. Click within the dashed box again to rotate and skew instead. Always check the status bar at the bottom for additional hints while you edit objects. You can cut, copy, and paste any selected object with Control or Command and X, C, and V, undoing with Control or Command and Z. At the top, the Tool Controls bar provides additional options for the selected object. Rotate it by 90 degrees, flip it horizontally or vertically, set its visibility order, or adjust position, width, and height precisely using the lock button to save the aspect ratio. These values get updated if you edit the object from the canvas. When you double-click on any object, you enable the related tool on the go. For example, double-click on any text to enable the text tool and type in, or double-click on any rectangle to enable its tool and either reshape it or drop other shapes. When you double-click on any path, you enable the node tool right away. Click on any node to select it and show its handles according to its type. You get diamonds for cusp nodes and squares for smooth nodes with tangent handles. You can shift node type by clicking on it while holding down the Control key. Move any node to adjust the path shape and use the handles to refine curves properly. Add new nodes by double-clicking on any path and use the backspace key to remove any node selected. You can use the Node tool on shapes to edit these with strong limitations. To fully customize these, you have to go to Path, Object to Path, to convert the shape into a path and fully edit it with the Node tool as seen. You can convert text as well, obtaining a group of individual letters that you can modify with the Node tool. To adjust any object appearance, open the Fill and Stroke panel from the Object tab. Select any object from the canvas, and under Fill, apply solid colors or any linear, radial, or pattern gradient. Switch to Stroke Paint to customize the object perimeter with solid colors or gradient, and open Stroke Style to add dashes, patterns, or markers to the perimeter. At the bottom, adjust the blur and transparency levels of the entire object taken as a whole. To manage gradients, enable the Gradient tool. Click and drag over a selected object to add any gradient and adjust its appearance by dragging its nodes. You can also select any node and edit its color and transparency from the Fill and Stroke panel on the right. Add more nodes by double-clicking on the gradient line and click elsewhere to apply all. To manage patterns, enable the Node tool to edit its single sample on the canvas. You may select multiple objects to move and edit these together. Just click and drag on the canvas and include all of these within the rectangular selection area. Deselect all with the Escape key. You can also right-click and go to Group to group all objects together, so that you can move and edit these as a single entity. With Inkscape, you can also work with bitmap images, such as objects made of pixels and not defined by a markup language. Import any image with File, Import, and edit it with the Selector tool. You can also apply effects from the Filters tab, or convert the image into a group of vectors by going to Path, Trace Bitmap, selecting between a single or a multicolor scan. This simplifies the image and gives you the possibility to edit it as a vector. From Object, Layers and Objects, you get the list of all the objects of your canvas within a default layer called Layer 1. Click on any object or layer to select it on the canvas, and click on the first button on the right to adjust opacity and blending mode. Use the eye icon to hide or show any object, and the lock button to block any modification. You can also right-click to duplicate and remove the object, or pull this up or down to rearrange the order of visibility. To create a new layer, head to Add Layer at the top and drag any object into it. These layers help you organizing a complex canvas into big groups of objects. To save your work, go to File, Save As. Choose Inkscape SVG or Plain SVG to save your canvas content and reopen it on Inkscape for further editing. To export your canvas, go to File, Export, and open the Export panel on the right. This shows four options. Choose Document to export the entire canvas, Page to export a specific page, Selection to export only the object you have selected, and Custom to export a custom region, with the top left corner of the canvas taken as a reference point. At the bottom, set the destination folder and file format, selecting SVG or PDF to save transparency. Always check the preview, fixing the canvas background with background color. You can export with a colored background or add any transparency by decreasing the alpha channel. Thank you very much for watching today's tutorial on Inkscape. We hope you learned a little bit about it for the beginner. Now, if you'd like to learn more about Inkscape in a little bit more in-depth setting, be sure to go to the comment sections and follow the link, which will take you to our course on Inkscape that's on Udemy. And remember, for more free tips, tricks, and tutorials, don't forget to visit our YouTube channel or our website, where you'll find hundreds of softwares that you can use for many different applications, including your daily designing. See you next time.